एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू चैप्टर 4 डेटा हैंडलिंग ऑफ क्लास 8। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट इंटरप्रेट्स डेटा थ्रू ग्राफ एंड सर्कल ग्राफ, प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड सम टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू प्रोबेबिलिटी। व्हाट इज डेटा? डेटा इज इंफॉर्मेशन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, 10 children like to play basketball, 10 children like to play football, scores of a student in a class, heights of players in a football team, all are the examples of a data. Data is everywhere. We can collect the data from TV, we can collect the data from books, newspapers and from Google. Is data and what are the types of graph? Information, especially facts or numbers collected for use, is called data. Each numerical fact is called an observation. Data is usually collected in the context of a situation that we want to study. For example, a teacher may like to know the average height of students in her class. To find this, she will write the heights of all the students of her class, organize the data in a systematic manner and then interpret it accordingly. Sometimes data is represented graphically to give a clear idea of what it represents. Now some types of graph: pictograph, bar graph, double bar graph, pie chart or circle graph. A pictograph, pictorial representation of data using symbols. For example, this pictograph represents the number of houses in different apartments. A bar graph, a display of information using bars of uniform width, their heights being proportional to the respective values. Double bar graph, a bar graph showing two sets of data simultaneously. It is useful for the comparison of the data. Now, the next topic is pie chart. What is pie chart? How to construct it? What is pie chart? A pie chart is a circular diagram in which the components or observation are represented by the sectors of a circle. The size of each sector is proportional to the magnitude of the component or the observation. It represents the whole circle, depicts the sum of the values of the component. In each sector shows a fraction to the total. Pie charts are also called the circle graph. Now the formula for calculating the central angle for a component equals to value of the component upon sum of the values of component multiply 360 degrees. Now the steps to construct a pie chart. First step is calculate the central angle for each component. Second is draw a circle of convenient radius. Third one is in the circle, draw sectors corresponding to the central angles calculated in step 1. Next, step 4th is shade or color each sector differently. Step number 5, label each sector. See the example of pie chart. The favorite flavors of ice cream for students of a school is given in percentage. Flavors are chocolate, vanilla and other flavors, and percentages: chocolate 50%, vanilla is 25% and other flavors are also 25%. Let us represent this data in a pie chart. The total angle at the center of a circle is 360 degrees. The central angle of the sectors will be a fraction of 360 degrees. We make a table to find the central angle of the sectors. Flavors are chocolate, vanilla and other flavors. Students are given 50%, 25% and 25%. Firstly, we will convert it into fractions. 50 upon 100, simplest form is 1 upon 2. 25 upon 100, 1 upon 2. Again, the next one is 1 upon 2. Now, we want to calculate the central angle. So, 1 by 2 multiply 360 degree, that is 180 degree. Similarly, 1 by 4 multiply 360 degree, 49 ja 36, 90 degree. Next one is again 1 by 4, so 1 by 4 multiply 360 degree, that is 90 degree. Steps for constructing a pie chart. First point is draw a circle of any convenient radius. Mark its center as O and radius as OA. Second point is the angle of the sector for chocolate is 180 degree. So construct the angle 180 degree. Third point is continue marking the remaining sectors, that is for vanilla we will construct the angle of 90 degree and other flavors also 90 degree. Chance and probability. Sometimes it happens that during rainy season you carry a raincoat every day and it does not rain for many days. However, by chance one day you forget to take the raincoat and it rains on that day. We face a lot of situations such as these where we take a chance and it does not go the way we want it to. We, however, consider here certain experiments whose results have an equal chance of occurring. The possible results we get when a coin is tossed are head or tail. Head or tail are the two outcomes of this experiment. Probability. The probability of an event is the measure of the chance of it occurring. It varies from 0 to 1. Probability of a sure event is 1 and an impossible event is 0. Now, what is an impossible event? Impossible event, for example, a coin is tossed, then the possible outcomes are either head or tail. And the question is, we want to calculate the probability of getting a number 6. This type of events are impossible events. Next definition is of an experiment. An operation which produces well-defined outcomes is called an experiment. For example, rolling a dice to see what random number comes up. Random experiment. An experiment which, when repeated under identical conditions, does not produce the same result or outcome every time is known as a random experiment. In this type of experiment, all possible outcomes are known and the exact outcome cannot be predicted as it may be any one of the outcomes. For example, a coin is tossed. Possible outcomes are either head or tail. These are the possible outcomes, but the exact outcome, either head will come or tail will come, that is the exact outcome, cannot be predicted. These types of experiments are known as random experiment. Outcome as event. Each outcome of an experiment or a collection of outcomes make an event. For example, in the experiment of toss a coin, getting a head is an event and getting a tail is also an event. In case of throwing a dice, getting each of the outcomes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6 is an event. That is, probability of an event equals to number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. Now see some examples. First example is a coin is tossed. What are the possible outcomes? We know that when a coin is tossed, either head will come or tail will come. That is, the possible outcomes are head or tail. Second question, a coin is tossed. What is the probability of getting these outcomes? First one is a head and the second one is a tail. When a coin is tossed, we know that the possible outcomes are head or tail. In the first part, I want to calculate the probability of getting a head. We know that when we will toss a coin, number of head will be 1. That is, the favorable outcome is 1 and the total outcomes are 2. So the probability of getting a head equals to number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes, that is 1 upon 2. Similarly, number of tails are 1 and the probability of getting a tail is 1 upon 2. In question number 3, a dice is thrown. What is the probability of getting these outcomes? In the first part, a number greater than 3, and in the second part, a number not greater than 5. When we will throw a dice, we know that the possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. That is, the total number of outcomes are 6. In the first part, the numbers which are greater than 3 are 4, 5, and 6. That is, the favorable outcomes are 3 and the total outcomes are 6. So the probability of getting a number greater than 3 equals to 3 upon 6. Convert it into its simplest form, answer will be 1 upon 2. Second part, a number not greater than 5. That is, jo 5 se greater nahi hai. That numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4 and the number 5 itself. So the favorable outcomes are 5 and the total outcomes are 6. Hence, therefore, probability of getting a number not greater than 5 equals to 5 upon 6. Thank you.